Hey friends, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Anar and I'm a self-taught software developer, and on this channel I help you break into and grow in the tech industry. Make sure you subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any of my future content, and if you find this video useful, give it a like. Today I wanted to go through what I think are the top 3 programming languages for you to learn as a junior developer in Canada for 2021. I believe these are the 3 programming languages that will open the most doors for you as a junior developer. Let's start from the bottom. Number 3 would have to be Java. Java is as popular as ever, and it's not going anywhere anytime soon. Large corporations, banks, and government organizations are heavily invested and bound to Java. Large complicated systems within these organizations that were written in Java decades ago cannot be easily rewritten or replaced. Because these existing systems need to be maintained, and often additional things need to be built on top of them, there will always be a demand for Java developers. Learning and becoming more experienced with Java is also going to open doors to more modern programming languages that were built on top of Java, such as Kotlin and Scala. If you have only worked with dynamically typed programming languages like Python, working with Java will make you a better software developer. You will not only gain experience, but also be able to reason about the benefits and drawbacks of using a statically typed programming language instead of a dynamically typed one. Another great thing about Java is that it's a flexible programming language. It opens doors to a variety of different types of work beyond web development. You can become an Android app developer, desktop app developer, or a big data engineer, just to name a few. If we look at how many job postings come up if we search for Java in Canada on indeed.ca, we get over 5,000 results, which is a lot for just one programming language. Java is great, but we still have 2 more languages to cover, so let's move on to number 2, Python. Python's popularity has skyrocketed over the last couple of years. If we search for Python in Canada on Indeed, we get almost 6,000 results back. It's a very easy and pleasant programming language, which makes it great for a junior developer. Just like Java, there's a lot of different things you could build with Python. It has applications in machine learning, big data, and web development. And because it's so easy to work with, it's also a very popular choice for scripting. Python is a great language to have in your toolkit because you will probably use it at some point even if you never become a Python developer. And this leads me to my number 1 programming language, JavaScript. Since JavaScript is the only programming language that web browsers understand, if you want to be a front-end developer, you pretty much have to learn it. Another great reason to learn JavaScript is because you can develop entire full-stack applications using just JavaScript. For example, Node.js is a popular backend framework, and couple that with a popular front-end framework like React, and you can build a serious web app. The JavaScript ecosystem is maturing and evolving as well. Again, because web browsers only understand JavaScript, it's probably the least likely programming language to ever become obsolete. JavaScript is also flexible, probably even more so than Python or Java. You can develop front-end applications, back-end applications, mobile apps, and games with it. If we look at Indeed again, we get almost 5,500 job postings in Canada if we just search JavaScript. Since most of these jobs are web development jobs, there's going to be less variation in the required skill sections of the job postings when compared to Java or Python jobs. These are my top 3 programming languages for you to learn in Canada for 2021. I hope this helps you make an informed decision when choosing what programming language to learn next. If you have any questions, feel free to drop them in the comment section. I'm going to wrap it up here, and I'll see you in the next one.